do we take 5 Newton force? I will make angle. How much it is given? 60. Are you able to understand? So you may speak with me, not with your friend. Okay? So you may give the answer. 60 degree. This will be F2. Of course, this is vector. This is also vector. F2 will be 5. Now what they want? They act on a body. So two forces are there, which are acting at a time on a body. How many forces? Two forces. That is a single force that balances two forces. The equilibrium force is directed at the actor of. What they are asking? They are asking equilibrium force. So, in our language, we can call that force to be F net or resultant force. What do you call it as? Resultant force or net force. Is that correct? Yes or no?
Yes.
F net. So, F net will be my equilibrium force. Theek hai beta? F net. So, you know that how we can get F net? We will do the vector addition. Yes or no?
Yes.
F net, vector addition. Okay. Very simple. F1 plus F. Getting my point?
Yes.
Now, they want the angle. Read the question. Okay. I hope you are having the sheet with you or some question with you. The equilibrium force, that is the single force that balances the two forces, is directed at the angle of. So let me make it simple. What they want? You are provided with two forces. One is 3 Newton, one is 5 Newton, making angle 60 degrees. And you want to calculate the resultant angle made by the resultant. Triangle law, all of you. You know triangle law? If you don't know, then I will write over here. Okay? According to that, or parallelogram law, better. They are not different, they are same. Okay. So, suppose this is the result. So, what I have done? I have completed the parallelogram. Resolve.
Yes.
I have completed the parallelogram. And now this will be my R. So, R will serve as F. Resolve.
Yes.
So, my F net will be. That you are doing? Magnitude. How much it is? Tell me. You may tell. Pula. So, pula the result. No problem. Magnitude of result? A plus B. F1 square. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
Plus F2 square. Plus 2 F1 F2. Cos of the angle between them. But I don't want this. What I want? Angle. So, what is the angle? This is the angle made by resultant with our 3 Newton force. That will be your 5. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
What is that? That can be taken as 5. So what is the formula for tan 5? You are knowing that tan 5. How to remember that? Just one formula. A and B are vectors. Suppose this is A and this is B. Then what we call it as? B sin theta upon A plus B cos theta. Are you getting my point? Is there any doubt? Okay. Is it that much of doubt? No, it's very simple. So tan 5 will be B 1 of 5 Newton. So 5 sin 60 upon 60. Theta value is like 60. And upon A. A means 3 plus cos 60. 5. How much is the value of sin 60? Root 3 by 2. Are you sure? No. Root 3 by 2. How much is the value of cos 60? Of course, 1 by 2. Yes or no?
Yes.
So, 1 by 2. 3 plus 1 by 2. How much it is? 3 to the? Yes. 1 by 2 will become, na? 18. Na? B cos theta. So, it will become 3 plus 5 cos 6. Sorry. B sin theta upon A plus B cos theta. Na? B cos theta. So, it will be 5 into 1 by 2. So, it will be 5 by 2. So, 3 to the? 6. 6 plus 5? 11 by 2, and that will be 5 root 3 by 2. So how much it will come? 2 to be made by 7. That will be 5 root 3 by 11. So So you may check with your answer. Are you having? 5 will be tan inverse. Are you sure? Let me check. Option B will be there. Hai na? You already understood? You people also asking? Okay. Don't give the answer. Just confirm it. So that was the question 1. Is there any doubt? Shall we go for question number 2? Now I will pick up the speed. Okay, slowly, slowly I will have some increase in my velocity. Okay, so our momentum will also get increased. Okay. So now we go for question number 2. For question number 2, what is asked? It's very simple. It is related with your error analysis. Your unit and dimension is there, no? In that error analysis topic is there. It is related with that. Okay, it's very simple. Those who are not able to understand, they may jot down the solution. If the error in the measurement of radius of sphere, so 2%, so radius is r, so they are giving the percentage error in the radius. So I can write delta r upon r is percent. How much it is? 2%. Are you sure?
Yes.
And what they are asking? Error in the determination of volume. So what they ask? Delta V by V is equal to question mark. Okay. So what is that? Sphere is there, na? Sphere. So will you tell me the formula for volume of a sphere? Yeah. What is the formula for volume of a sphere? Yes. 4 by 3 pi r cube. That's all. So V is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay. Now you have to keep in mind one formula. Here, do you know constant quantities and variable quantities? The quantities which will not change, those will be constant. 4 is constant, 3 is constant, and pi is constant. R may change, na, according to it will change the sphere. So it is the variable. So can I write V is proportional to R cube?
Yes
or no? So if V is proportional to R cube, then I can directly write delta V by V, okay, is equal to, how is the power? Okay, no need to write this, directly also you can write. Okay, so if X is equal to A raised to N and B raised to N, this is the rule, suppose, then what I can write? Delta X upon X percentage will be N into delta A upon A percent plus N into delta B upon B percent. Okay, same formula we will use over here. What will we get? Samasya sir. Okay, so what will be there? R cube is there. So what will the formula now? 3 into delta R upon R percent. So 3 multiplied by delta R upon R percent. What is delta R upon R percent given? So 2, 3 is a 6. Is it there? Option? In my copy, there is no option for second and third. What do you want?
Option देता ना
First day.
So again, we will continue with our discussion. That will come out to be 6%. Understood, everybody?
Yes.
Shall we go further? Now, question number 3. How many of you solved question number 3? Raise your hands. Nobody? Was it difficult? How do you understand? Okay. These type of questions are very easy actually. Once you get practice, then you have the idea of that, how to solve. Question 3, solution. So let me read the question. The position x of a particle varies with time as c, t is equal to at square minus vt cube, and the acceleration of the particle will be 0 at time t equal to. So acceleration of particle at time t is equal to 0, na? Na. Acceleration of the particle is 0, so find time. Hai na? Find the time t. Are you yes or no?
Yes.
Are you comfortable?
Yes.
Now sit straight, beta. Now we are not in home. Now we are actually. Sit straight. Then otherwise you will feel sleepy. Hai na? Okay. That's why. We are not habitual, na? We are habitual for sitting in home and doing our work. So very simple it is. First you write in your notebook that if you want to calculate velocity from displacement, so displacement to velocity, differentiate one time. So if you want to go for velocity from displacement, we have to differentiate. Again, if we want acceleration from velocity, if we want a from velocity, again you differentiate. So what is this? V is equal to dx by dt. Differentiation of x with respect to time. I will explain you how to do differentiation and all. If you don't know, somebody may not be knowing that. I will explain. And acceleration will be dv by dt. So what is our first duty? From the given equation, first you have to calculate dx by dt. Yes or no? You will get V. Again you differentiate, you will get. Okay. So what they want? Acceleration, na? Acceleration 0 there. Okay. So will you tell me the value of acceleration? First tell me value of velocity. Tell. T name. Sorry. This is not V. This is X. Sorry, very slow. This is X, not T. How will you get if it is T? X. So what will you dx by dt? V is equal to dx by vt. What will value? D by dt of this. Differentiation. How will you do? T square. What is the differentiation of T square? Which rule you will use? X to the power n. If you don't know, leave here. No problem. Okay. From right now you must be knowing. After I have taught you. Nx raised to n minus 1. You have to operate this. If you have to differentiate. N is here 2. 2 into x is 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. So, derivative of x square. What we need? 2x. Derivative of x cube, 3x square. X is to 4, 4x cube. Got the idea? 2x square. What will be derivative? 2x square. 2 will be outside. Constants are outside. And x square derivative? 2x. So 2x into 2. That will be 4x. So here, it is a t square. So t square derivative will be 2t multiplied by a. So will it be 2at? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Minus what is bt cube? You will tell me. Now t cube derivative 3t square. And this is b. So 3bt square. Yes or no?
Yes.
I got b. Now what is my t? Find out a. What is a then? Acceleration dv by dt. Do it. Now you may do. Tell me. Just tell me. 2a outside. What is the derivative of t itself? T derivative always 1. Power is 1. Na? So nx raised to n minus 1. 1 minus 1 0. T to the power 0 will be 0. 1. And 1 into that. So that will be 1. So x with respect to x will be 1, t with respect to t it will be 1. So it will be 1. So it will be 2a into 1 minus 3b. What is the derivative of t square? 2t. Yes. So 2t. So shall I write 2a minus 3pt is equal to my acceleration? Yes or no? And what they are giving? Acceleration of the particle is 0. So we equate this with 0. So can I write 2a minus 3pt equals 0? Yes or no?
Yes.
Then what I will get? 2a equals 3pt. And what will be t? 8, right?
Yes.
3 plus 6 will come, sorry, very sorry. 6 it will come, very sorry. So it will be 2a upon 6b is the 6. A upon 3b, it will come. Is it coming? The third is the option. Third option is the correct option. So I hope, dear friends, you are able to understand that. Okay, I'm speaking to you. Okay, let's start with question number 4. So till then you write that. If you do have any query, afterwards you may ask. Okay? Shall I run this?
Yes.
Or shall I stop? Or wait for a while?
Yes.
Question number 4 is related with projectile. So what I will do, beta? I will not pamper you, okay? Projectile, all the questions I will discuss with you separately. Are you comfortable with that? Because at a time all the chapters I will take, then you will know nothing. You will say that, sir, I am not able to digest this. Okay, projectile questions we will discuss later. Okay, that I think. Kinematics we can discuss. Okay, now question number 5. So you may write over there that question number 4 will be discussed live. Shall I run this? Shall I in this must need someone? Sure. Question number 5. Let me repeat. Question number 4 will be discussed later. It is on projectile. So I will start with question number 5. Question number 5 is about kinematics. A car travels first 1/3 of its total distance. First 1/3 of its total distance with a speed of v1, and next 2/3, correct, next 2/3 with speed of v2. Getting a point? Okay, the average speed. Okay, so first of all let me write the formula for v average. One of the formula, v average. What is the formula for v average? Total, what? Total distance traveled, hai na? I should write total distance traveled upon what? Boli beta, total. Now it is our duty to find out what is the total distance traveled and what is the total time. Suppose I consider this total to be, total distance to be s and total time to be t. Okay. So suppose I will first go from A to B. So can I call this time to be t1?
Yes.
So t1 is the time to go from A to B and t2 is the time to go from B to C. So what will be total time? T will be t1 plus t2, that's all. Okay. Speed is equal to distance travelled upon time divided. Yes or no? So v1, how I can write v1? Distance travelled 1/3 of s. So can I write s by 3? How about that?
Yes.
S by 3 upon time t1. Yes or no? So s by 3 upon t1. So what will be value of t1? S by 3 upon v1. So can I call t1 to be equal to s by 3 v1? Yes or no?
Yes.
That's all. So will you calculate now t2 and tell me the value? t2 will be 8. What will be distance? 2s by 3 upon speed v2. So it will be by V directly and 2 upon V2. What it will be? 2S upon 3V2. Is that clear? Now I do have V1 also, T2 also. Put the value, get the result. S upon, how much it is? S by 3V1 plus S by, sorry, 2S by 3V2. Now can I cancel S? I can take S common and cancel with that. So I will get 1 by, what will be remaining? 1 by 3V1, array solve, plus 2 by 3V2. Will you do that now? Yes. 3V2 plus 3V2 plus 6V1 upon 9V1 V2. Array solve. That is 1 by, na? Array solve. That is 1 by. 1 by is na? Okay. So, can I write 9V1 V2 upon 3, sorry, like that I mean, 6V1 plus 3V2. So, can I take 3 common? Array solve. If I take 3 common, then what will happen? 3 will be common. So, 3 3 is a 9. So, here I will get 3V1 V2 upon 3 2 is a 6. 2V1, array solve. 2V1 plus 3 1 is a 3. So, plus V2. So, will you check the option? Whether you are getting this option?
Yes.
Okay, that's all. That was our problem number 5. Okay. Any doubt? Any query? Shall we proceed? What you want to write? Write it fast. Till that I will speak with those students. So, dear student, please write this. If you do have any query, any doubt, ask. There's no problem. Yes, please.
This will be the slope m, array solve.
Then it is C. If y is equal to mx, then C will be 0. Then the graph will be straight line passing through origin. Yes or no? Suppose if it is coming minus, then how my graph will look like? Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay. This is the answer actually. Now how it comes, that will discuss. Now just now I have explained you how to calculate the velocity, or yes or no, speed. So velocity will be differentiation of x with respect to t. So what will become v? V will be dx by dt. So will you differentiate this? Okay, any one of you? Yes, brother, last fellow. Will you try? अभी सीखा है ना मैंने, थोड़ा ट्राई कर सकते हो, थोड़ा तो कड़ा रहने का तो कोशिश करो। हाँ ओके, बस आधा तो निकल गया, चलो आधा भी आएगा। बोलो सिक्स ये कांस्टेंट है ना, उसका डेरिवेटिव कितना आएगा? कांस्टेंट का डेरिवेटिव जीरो आता है। अभी बताया तो ध्यान दे, फिर से पूछा तो आना चाहिए आंसर। इसका आंसर रहेगा जीरो माइनस बैठ। यस बेटा स्लो। फोर टी Is that okay, na?
Yes.
I don't know about you people. Sir, it's okay. What I can do now? So projectile, you are knowing that basically when we project something into the space, it goes like something. Will you catch it? This is the projectile. Okay. We'll do it thrice. Okay. With you, because in front of camera and there. So you keenly observe what I am doing. So right now I will do it. Nice practice. So I will do like this. Okay. I'll give some velocity initially. Oh, just me. Okay. So what is happening here? A body is projected in the air. We have to neglect the resistance of the air. But body will go with in the presence of gravity. It will go. So body will have two options that you are knowing. Body will go up also. It is going up, no? But not directly like this. Body will go up also. The same time body will go to your right. Same. For me it is to left. For you it is to the. So whatever we will calculate, it will have two motions: vertical motion and horizontal motion. But that is not separate. That is a combined vertical and horizontal motion. Are you getting my point? So if it is having vertical and horizontal motion, of course it will have two paths. One path will be one. Two positions. One is y and one is x. Are you getting my point? Once it will go up while going up or coming down, I will take the acceleration to be equal to g or minus g. And once it is going here, okay, nobody is trying to stop that. Yes or no? I have neglected air resistance. So if it is going like that, in this direction, there is no factor which is opposing that. Okay, so I will draw the projectile like this now. Suppose this is the first initial velocity. Okay. So if it is u. So of course, what I have given some angle ratio to theta related with theta made with x axis. Now it will go like this suppose. And you are knowing that this is the maximum height, this is the range. Yes or no? Okay. This is what is the angle of projection. Now, I will have two velocities. One component will be horizontal component, that is x component. So what will be ux? Of course, u cos theta, yes or no? Triangle, yes or no? My dear friends, this is suppose x, then this will be x. How much is this? Cos theta, this will be x. Sin theta, okay. So ux will be u cos theta and uy will be u sin. So this is the velocity along x. Nobody is stopping the body along x. So ux will be kept constant automatically. So if the velocity of the body is kept constant, then acceleration will be zero. So there will not be any acceleration. Now, here, as the body is going up, it is going in the presence of gravitational acceleration. So, its velocity will go on decreasing. Simple, if I keep it like this.